I'm confused. But I don't like this place.
Hi guys, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Sneha and welcome to the end of the year. So today I'm about to kick off all of my end of the year kind of videos that I want to make this year. Just generally talking about the best books that I've read, the not so favorite, my least favorite books that I've read, my reading plans, how have they fared, my reading plans for 2022, all that kind of good stuff, that optimism that a new year brings. I am full of that today. But today's video is going to be about my did not finished books for the second half of 2021. I made one of these videos in the early first half of the year, I think around May or June, and since then I've DNF'd quite a few books, so I wanted to talk about them as well. This might be a little bit of a salty video, so a little bit of a disclaimer before I start off. These are just my opinions. You are very, very entitled to your own opinions as well. Just don't come after me for my own opinions, and I won't come after you for your opinions. And okay. But anyway, that's the little bit of disclaimer that I wanted to give. This year, more than ever before, I think, I have DNF'd books very freely. There have been quite a few stretches of time where I just had too much going on and I just could not get into books. And if I did pick up a book that really irked me in a certain way, maybe because of the writing, maybe because of the characters, I very freely gave it up and moved right along. And I think that's a healthy thing for me. I think that's a good thing for me. So hoping to keep that going in the years to come. But let's get started. I have a few books to talk to you about today. And here we go. The first book I kind of DNF'd was Big Magic by Elizabeth Gilbert. Out of the five non-fictions that I picked up this year, one of them is I did not finish. You can tell how that one particular reading goal went. But anyway, this is kind of like a self-help book. Elizabeth Gilbert is the writer of Eat, Pray, Love and City of Girls, I think her most recent work. And she in this particular book talks about what creativity means to her, what creative living means to her, how she envisions creative thinking and creative living. So she just basically talks about her thoughts about the same. I actually did get quite a bit through this. If you can see, I've annotated it quite well as well, but I just towards the end it just began to lose me because it felt like the same point was being dragged over and over and over again. Like, you can see where my attention began to kind of wane off towards the last, you know, 1/4 of the books or 2/5 of the books. But this, I don't know, she talks about creativity as being like this mystical force that is just like floating above everybody's heads, and it's up to the person who wants to get that creativity to kind of grab that and churn it into all these different forms of art, like writing, like music, like art, like all of these different forms. I don't know if I quite agree with that just generalization of, you know, ideas being somewhere floating around in the atmosphere and anybody can really pick them up and take them forward. I don't think I strictly agree with that, but she does put forward quite a compelling argument for the same. But again, like I said, it just drags on a lot towards the second half where she kind of expounds the same things over and over again. And another thing that really didn't catch a hold of me towards the second half is she talks with this kind of fake humility. Like, she's a very successful author by all means, right? By all accounts, she's an amazing, excellent commercial writer who has been revered the world over for her books. So for her to say things like, it wasn't really me, it was this mystical force that came into me and presented me with a story, I don't quite agree with that, specifically because Eat, Pray, Love is kind of like her own memoir. So I think she is taking a little too much away from herself, and that started to rub me the wrong way, you know, in the later half of the book. So that's why I ended up not finishing this book, and I don't think I'm going to go back. The next book that I did not finish was A Spool of Blue Thread by Anne Tyler. This was a book that I borrowed from my library, and it's quite a thick book, I would say. That's the one thing that has stood out for me. I think it was around 400-ish pages. But this is basically a family drama kind of a story. It's about this one family in Baltimore, and they are like this multi-generational, really joint kind of family. Like everybody gets along with everybody. Everybody's really happy with each other's relationship. There is no like animosity anywhere and all of that, except for like, I think there's one younger brother who's kind of like the outlier in the family. There's a reunion in the family. I'm sorry if I'm paraphrasing this book exactly, because I don't really remember what happened, but I remember the specific point where I was like, nope, I'm done. So anyway, there's like this kind of like a family reunion of everybody in like the, you know, family house, family home, where like multi-generations who are meeting after quite a bit of a gap. So they all meet, and then there's like a family secret which is revealed. And just the point that irked me is that this bombshell has been dropped in the middle of dinner or something, I don't remember. But there's no reaction. There's no reaction from any of the characters. Like, secret reveal, everybody's like, oh. Okay, and then they go on serving like mashed potatoes and eat turkey or whatever American things that they can do. I'm like, hello, your entire genre is like a family drama, right? Like, if there's a secret reveal, I want to know what each character is going through. I want to know about their emotions. I want to know what they're thinking. I want to know what changes in the relationship between these characters. But there's no emotion on display. And it left me with this visual of, you know, a comic book which has been left out in the sun for too long. Like, the characters, like, the drawings start to, like, fade. That's how I think of this book as. Like, the characters, I felt like a pale shadow of what they are supposed to be, of what I expected them to be. But they really were not. So, I ended up leaving this book aside, and I have no intention of going. Then we have A Question of Blood by Ian Rankin. This is a murder mystery, and I think this is the first time in my life that I DNF'd a murder mystery. And then I followed it up by DNFing another murder mystery. I'll get to that soon. But this, I think Ian Rankin is a very popular like paperback kind of a writer for these murder mysteries. This particular book is about a private school where two teenagers are shot to death. And they are shot by this ex-army kind of loner man, who immediately after shooting them, he turns the gun on himself and he also dies. So it kind of like shakes the community of this school, and everybody's just disturbed. And two police officers come down to investigate, but they also have their own battles to fight, as with every murder mystery novel. This book is just boring. I thought the mystery was too long drawn out. There were too many names, there were too many things that kept getting added into the mix, but it did not make it any more interesting. It just dragged down the entire plot, I thought. And it is not an easy read as well, because of, I think, just the chunkiness of the scene setting that happens with this book. It's not that well phrased out, according to me. Please don't come for me if there are any Ian Rankin fans out there. But it was just too slow. It was too plodding. I lost interest like 40% into this book. And for the very first time, I was not invested enough to find out who the real murderer was. Like, I couldn't even guess, because there were just like these million little plot holes which were introduced but did not make it interesting. So I could not guess who the murderer was, but I also really wasn't interested in finding out who the murderer was. So I ended up not finishing this book. And it's a new high or a low, depending on how you see it for me. And back to back, I had two did not finishes, which started off with Beautiful World, Where Are You? I talked about this book, I think in the book haul that I did, where I talked about buying this book and trying to read it. But I'll link that up and down below, do check that out. But I realized Sally Rooney is not for me. This is the story of two friends who are girls, and they live in different cities. One's a writer, one's like a regular old like corporate lawyer, something like that. And they find these new men in their lives, and they start this correspondence over emails. They talk about these men, they talk about other things, they talk about like these deep questions that they have about humanity and society and civilization. And we see the story evolve through the letters and also with the scenes of these individual characters. Like I said, I've realized Sally Rooney is probably not for me. I'm a little bit too old to get into like these, oh, what a paradigm shift in thinking kind of a thing. I'm becoming more practical as I grow up. I'm in the wrong side of my 20s now, but this just was not for me. I really could not relate to any character. They were unbelievably pompous to me. They were really, like, their problems were just too young, you know, like boy problems, and I just could not get into them. And for me, if I don't like the characters, it's really difficult for me to like a particular book, unless, like, you know, the characters are deliberately written that way to get you invested in this book. This book is not written like that. The characters are meant to sound relatable to you. I could tell, but they were just not relatable to me, and I ended up DNFing this book very, very soon into the game. So yeah, sorry. The immediate next book which I had picked up was A Murder in Mahim by Jerry Pinto, and I ended up DNFing this as well. This is again a murder mystery. This never happened in my life that I did not finish a murder mystery, and in 2021 I did not finish two murder mysteries. I did not expect that, but this is the story of, this is set in Mumbai, by the way, so that's why I picked it up, because I live in Mumbai. Mahim is like a locality very close to where I live, actually, so I was a little intrigued. So in this particular book, there is a dead body which is discovered in the toilet of the Mahim local railway station, and the inspector and the main character, the protagonist, is a retired crime journalist. So they team up, like they have like this long-standing friendship where sometimes he helps, the reporter helps with the cases of the policeman. So they team up for this particular case as well, and they try to find out who the murderer was. They kind of discover like this underbelly of Mumbai, the kind of like the lowly side, the almost illegal crime side of it, and also the gay scene in Bombay, where a lot of young men have to hide their identities in secret because they are scared of being outed into the society. So it's just they're just two parallel things which are going on, where you're trying to solve a murder of this man who was involved in all these things, and you're also trying to digest this entire scene that the author is trying to paint. Again, I just could not get invested into this book. I think Jerry Pinto is meant to write contemporary fiction. He's meant to write literary fiction more than murder mysteries. So I just could not get into it. He did not write the murder mystery in an interesting enough way for me to really read it and find out who the murderer was. I think I kind of guessed it as well, but I don't really remember. So yeah, like I said, it was a forgettable book. I did not get into it. I want to read more of Jerry Pinto. This was my first book, actually, and he's a very famous Indian author. But I think I should give his lit fic books a chance rather than his murder mysteries, because personally, my personal opinion is that he's not really the best author to write mystery novels. So last did not finish book for this year is also an Indian book, but I really hope I can go back and really get into this. This is Charangi by Shankar. Talked about this in multiple videos, I think, in my haul, in another like end of the year book freak out tag or something like that. I'll link all the videos up above. This is the story of the Shah Jahan, which was a very famous hotel in Calcutta in the 1950s, and this young man called Shankar manages to get a job in the hotel. So in the process, he discovers all these various different characters who've been there since, like, you know, time immemorial, the history of the hotel, the patrons who regularly visit it. So this, it's like an entire microcosm of its own. I think I mentioned in my previous videos, I am really intrigued with books which are set in hotels, because just the juxtaposition of characters who have made it their home and the characters who briefly call it their home for a few days, it's just really interesting, I think, and the whole dynamics and the relationship between them. I unconsciously picked this up, I think, because of that intrigue that it holds for me. But I blame myself more than this book for not being able to get into it, because I was just not in the best state of mind. I was very tense, I was very anxious, and I just could not get into this book, and I don't blame it, but I hope to return to it someday, and I hope it reads me better. This is a Bengali novel which is translated by Arunava Sinha, and I've always wanted to read Arunava Sinha, so that's why I really know that I'm going to give this book another chance, and hopefully it'll go better than the first time. So yeah, I don't don't blame you. I really don't. It was my fault. And yeah, that's it. Those are all the books that I did not finish in the second half of the year. Like I said, 2021 has been a good year of reading with a few like downers in terms of books. But yeah, I will see you soon in another video where I talk about my 2021 reading updates. And thank you so much for watching. If you're here for so long, it means the world to me. Do like, share, comment, subscribe and all that jazz. And I'll see you very, very, very soon. Bye.